Good morning guys. Today we are going to solve one more problem, that is on how to evaluate your eigenvalues and eigenvectors for as linear or uniform cross-sectional part. Now sometimes I think I told you eigenvalues and eigenvectors, it is also known as, the problems will be given like this: determine the natural frequency and mode shapes. Natural frequency and mode shape for the given part problem. See, natural frequency nothing but your eigenvalue in a free vibration problem. Mode shape is nothing but your eigenvector. Don't expect that the problem will be given only to determine eigenvalue, eigenvector. They are given also, determine the natural frequency and mode shape for a longitudinal vibration of the constrained uniform circular bar as shown in figure. Consider minimum two elements. See, the concept right is given is consider minimum two elements. Why he has given minimum two elements? Because it is in a linear bar is given, a constant cross section. He has not divided it. You have to consider this as a two elements. Two elements means you have to divide exactly equally at the center. Now if you consider this, this will be made into like this. One, exactly at the center, I'm going to locate one more node. Two, exactly and one more at the end. That means two elements you should consider. How to consider two elements? Make exactly divide the center. Uniform cross section. Now, what is given? Pi is given 0.02 meters, length is given 0.25 meter, Young's modulus is given 210 GPa, density is given kg per meter cube, 7860 kg per meter cube. This is what the given dimensions. First, note on all the given dimensions, there is diameter to 0.02, that I am converting into millimeter. See, always I'll keep it, all the values should be in millimeter. If you want, you can do it in meter also, no problem. Now, I'm converting into millimeter. Now, 20 mm. Now using this, because if I want to determine any matrix, I require area, because mass matrix also have a factor called area, stiffness matrix also have a factor called area. Because of it, first I want to calculate area. What is area? Pi d square by 4 circular cross section. Pi into 20 square divided by 4, I had obtained 314.159 mm². Area is determined. Length 0.25 is there, 250. Okay, that is total length is 250 millimeter. Young's modulus is 210 GPa is given. I am converting into Newton per millimeter square, 2.1 into 10 power 5. 200 is there, means generally 2 into 10 power 5 you are making it. It is 210, 2.1 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square. Then density, kg per meter cube is given, because in all the dimensions I am taking in millimeter, I want to convert this into millimeter. That is 7860. Now meter cube, I am converting to millimeter cube, it will be 10 to the power minus 9 kg per millimeter cube. 7860 into 10 power minus 9 kg per millimeter cube. Now, see, same thing, whatever I written here, reflected one more thing, exactly I taken, exactly at the center, I divide into two elements, 0.25 mm, 125 mm. That means L1 is 125, L2 is also 125. Now, area is common. Okay, this is what your FE model, consisting of three nodes, 1, 2, 3, L1, L2. Now, if you take with respect to displacement, Q1, Q2, Q3. This is what you are going to get it. Capital, you can write it Q1, Q2, Q3, or small, you can write it Q1, Q2, Q3. This is what the problem given. Okay, determine the natural frequency and mode shape, or sometimes we call it as a eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Don't confuse in examination. If you had given eigenvalue and eigenvector, it is nothing but you are determining a natural frequency and mode shapes for the given problem. It is if it is a free vibration problem. Free vibration problem is there is no any force will be applied, only initial disturbance will be provided. All this. Now, go to next. What is your step 2? Step 2 is formulate element of stiffness matrix and mass matrix. Now, how to formulate your element of stiffness matrix? Given problem is a bar element. We know what is a bar element stiffness matrix. Stiffness matrix for bar element will be equals to AE by LE. Simple. 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. This is our element of stiffness matrix. Now, we know already K1, first element, A1, E1, L1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Now, how to determine this? Now, substitute all the values. K1 equals to area. Area calculated. 314.159. Correct? Yeah, 314.159 into Young's modulus 2.1 into 10 power 5 divided by, what is the length? 125. 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Now, if you solve this, you're going to get 10 power 5 common. 5.27, what is the value you're going to get it? Now, I write a 10 power 5 outside. 5.27 minus 5.27 minus 5.27, 5.27. This is your element of stiffness matrix 1. Now, similarly, for element 1, you should calculate what? Mass matrix. Because you are determining eigenvalue, eigenvector means what is the characteristic equation? Determinant of k minus lambda m. That means k is required, m is required. How to calculate m? Mass matrix. What mass matrix? Consistent mass matrix. Rho A, Le by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2. Now, substitute the values. What is your mass matrix? Me is equals to. What is density? Density is 7860 into 10 power minus 9. What is area? Same area, 314.159. Length is 125, then here the value is 6, then 2112. Now, if you solve, you are going to get 0.1028, 0.0514, 0.0514, 0.1515, 108. If you it is a little bit clumsy here, for that purpose I have write here 1 2 1 2. This is what your mass matrix. Now you have calculated for element number 1. Now repeat the same thing, repeat the same thing for element number 2. Element number 2, because k minus delta m means we required k is global stiffness matrix, m is your global mass matrix. Why here global stiffness matrix, global mass matrix is there? That means your calculate is elemental matrix, because you have one more element, you have to calculate that, then you should calculate your global matrix. For that purpose, go to next step, that is element number 2. Now how to calculate your element number 2? Now repeat the same thing, k2 is equals to a2, e2, l2, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. See, values are same, you are going to get a same matrix. Similarly, if mass matrix also, you are going to get a same matrix. Because values will not change, because same element will be same density, same diameter, even length is also same, because we only divide into equal parts. That is the one advantage. Okay, because of this, we are having the same mass matrix and same your stiffness matrix and mass matrix. Now, what is the next step? Make your global matrix and mass matrix. How to make your global matrix? Already we know that. See, if always you should determine global matrix, means you should write a matrix for continuum. If you want to write a matrix for continuum, how many displacements are there for continuum? If you observe, there are 3 displacements. 1, 2 and 3. That is node 1, node 2, node 3. Each node will have a single displacement. Okay, 3. Because of that, what happened here? The order of the matrix should be 3 cross 3. Now, make it your global stiffness matrix K. How to calculate 10 to the power 5? Now you know what is the, how to make your global matrix 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you can write down, then make arrangement of the values. Similarly, repeat the same step for even mass matrix, you are going to get a global mass matrix. Now after global mass matrix and your stiffness matrix, this is your global stiffness matrix and this will be your global mass matrix. This is what your next step, that means third step will be formulate your global stiffness matrix and mass matrix. This is how you should formulate it. Then after this, now next step is, what is the next step? Equilibrium equation for dynamic analysis and apply the boundary conditions. Now what is equilibrium? Here k minus delta m into x will be equal to 0. This is what your equilibrium is. Like your kq is equal to f in your simple problems. Now here k minus delta m into x will be equal to 0. Now what is k? Already you have obtained k right here. You know minus lambda. You know what is mass matrix you can return. Now x will be equal to q1, q2, q3, 0, 0, 0. Okay, this how you obtain this q1, q2, q3 means you should apply your x1 equals u sin omega t, or q sin omega t, q1 sin omega t, x2 equals to, like that you should make it, then you are going to get q will be common. Okay, that concept. Now after this, what is this? Now you obtain this. Now apply the boundary condition. See, what is boundary condition here? If you observe your problem, node 1 is completely fixed. Node 1 is completely fixed. That means that will act as your mean position. So if body has to oscillate, means there should be some fixed end will be there. Based on that, it has to oscillate. Based on that, it has to oscillate, because that is your fixed position. Now q1 will be equal to 0. Now if q1 will be equal to 0, what is your condition? Eliminate row with respect to node 1 and column with respect to node 1 similarly, correct? Now whatever remaining values are there, 10 power 5. Now here q1 is 0. Now eliminate first row. Eliminate. Elimination method means what? Eliminate first row and first column. First row and first column. See, if you eliminate this, what are remaining values there? Now write it. Say 10.54 minus 5.27. This value I had written. Similarly, I had written this value lambda into this 10 power 5. Now, see, after obtaining this, now it will be like a k minus lambda m of your previous problem, what we have solved. Okay, how to determine your eigenvalue and eigenvector. Now I am going with the eigenvalue. This also sometimes I will determine eigenvalue. I will write sometimes it will also call it as a determine the natural frequency, because free vibration. I have taken it as a 0. Mx double dot plus kx will be equal to 0. See, if you observe kx mx is equal to 0, it is like simple your free vibration problem. Now take this. Now how to make it? Now make a simplification of it. 10.54. We know what is the characteristic equation for determining your eigenvalue. That is k minus determinant of k minus lambda m will be equal to 0. Now you have to determine lambda. So to determine that, now 10.54 and 10 power 5. Now minus of 0. See, you make it k minus lambda m. This is what you are going to obtain. 10.54 and 10 power 5 minus 0.2056. This you can make a simplification here. You are going to get it. See, after the simplification, next step, see, you have done k minus lambda m, everything you have done it, correct? Now, write what are the values you are going to obtain. So you are going to obtain 10.54 into 10 power 5 minus 0.2056 lambda, correct? This is what the value, I am calculating determinant, okay, into 5.27 into 10 power 5. Minus 0.1028 lambda, okay, minus of next value 5.27 into 10 power 5 plus 0.0514 lambda whole square is equals to 0. That means if you simplify it, you are going to get this. See, if you go for still simplification of it, now that means multiply these values, you are going to get 55.54, 5 in 10 power 10, that means this into this. Now similarly, this into this, if you do it, you are going to get minus 1.0835 into 10 power 5 lambda, okay. Then next value, that is this into this, if you multiply it, you are going to get 1.0835 into 10 power 5 lambda. That is this into this, next this, plus 0.02113 lambda square. That means this is over minus of, now this is a plus b whole square. If you simplify it, 27.772 into 10 power 10 minus 2.64196 into 10 power minus 3 lambda square. That is this value. Next, minus 54.175 into 1756 in 10 power 3 lambda is equals to 0. This is what, if you solve this equation, you are going to get it. Or if you finalize this, make all the values arrangement, this lambda square value separate. If you make it lambda square value, this is lambda square minus 270.8756 into 10 power 3 lambda, okay, plus 27.773 into 10 power 10 is equals to 0. That means make lambda square values this and this, okay. Then lambda values 1, 2, 3 values of lambda, then constant, okay. Now it will be like a lambda 1 comma 2 is equals to like quadratic equation. How to determine the solution for quadratic equation? Minus b plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, if you substitute every value, b value, everything, now I'll substitute here lambda 1 comma 2 equals to, what is your b value? Minus 270. Minus into minus, plus 270.8756 into 10 power 3. Okay, plus or minus, inside b square directly I'll write square of that value. Square of that value is 73.3735 into 10 power 9. Minus 4ac also directly write it out. After multiplication, 4 into ac, if you multiply it, you're going to get 20.529 into 10 power 9. Divided by, what is 2a? 2a also after calculating, I'm going to get 0.03696. Now, if you simplify this, that is lambda 1 comma 2 is equal to, you're going to get 270.8756 in 10 power 3 plus or minus 229.8793 into 10 power 3 divided by 0.03696. If simplify it, you are going to get two values, lambda 1 and lambda 2. Always take lowest value will be your first frequency, highest value will be second frequency. Lowest natural frequency and highest natural frequency, because you are only getting two values, because order of the matrix is 2 cross 2, what you determine. Now, how to determine your natural frequency? This is also called as an eigenvalue. How to convert this into frequency? We know that omega square equals to lambda 1. Lambda 1 equals to square root of, omega square equals to lambda 1, omega 1 equals to lambda square root of lambda 1. If you calculate it, you are going to get, this is your natural frequency, 1.053 in 10 power 3 radians per second. Still, if you want to convert it, omega 1 by 2 pi hertz, okay, you are going to get it in terms of hertz. Similarly, lambda 2, omega 2 and f2, omega 2 and f2. This is called your frequency. How to determine your frequency, or how to determine your eigenvalue and eigenvector, eigenvalue. Okay, this up to this is eigenvalue. Now, after this, next step is how to determine your eigenvector. To determine your eigenvector, now I'm going to write this. Now, to determine eigenvector and mode shapes, this is called as a vector or sometimes mode shape. Mode shape means what? It gives the direction how it is oscillating. Vector or mode shape. Sometimes we call it as eigenvector or mode shape. Eigenvector will be using lambda 1. See, first, we know that k minus lambda m into x1 equals to 0. Already we know this k minus lambda m, previous one, x1 you can make it. Now, you want x1? X1 is q1, q2, q3. q1 equals to 0 or fixed position or mean position we call it. If it is q1 equals to 0, the equation becomes like this. Now, here, this. Now, what do you want to make it? Replace lambda by lambda 1 in this equation number 1. Above equation, replace lambda by lambda 1. If you replace it, what happens? Just substitute first. 10.54 into 10 power 5. Minus 0.2056 into lambda 1 is 1.1092 into 10 power 6. Similarly, minus 5.27 into 10 power 5 minus of 0.0514 into lambda is 1.1092 into 10 power 6. Okay. Similarly, minus 5.27 into 10 power 5. Okay. Minus of 0.0514 into 1.1092 into 10 power 6. Okay. Next, similarly, 5.27 into 10 to the 5 minus 0.1028 into 1.1092 into 10 power 6. That means multiply it. Okay. Then this will be what happen? Q2, Q3, and this will be 0, 0. Okay, 0, 0. Now, if you solve this, you are going to get, if you minus of this value is 825.948 minus 584.012, then minus 584.012, 412.974, you are going to get it into Q2, Q3 is equals to 0, 0. This is what you are going to get it. Now, to determine your eigenvector for this, now from the matrix, any of the equation, either you can use in, say, now if you obtain this, so you can use, you have to multiply this, correct? You can use either this equation or you can use either this equation. Any of the equation you are going to use, you get the same value. I am using first equation. First equation, that is 825.948 into 10 power 3 into Q2 minus 584.0.12 into 10 to power 3 into Q3 is equals to 0. If you solve, you are going to get Q3 equals to 1.41 into Q2. That is, we know that what is x1? X1 is in column wise Q2, Q3. If you write transpose, row wise Q2, Q3. What is Q2 now? Q2 is as it is. Q3 will be replaced by in terms of Q2. Now, to know the mode shape, now write it. See, if to determine your mode shape or vector using that, now you want to use a normalization technique. See, to use your normalization technique, you know what is normalization? X1 transpose M into X1. X1 transpose already there. M, we know mass matrix, what is after your elimination. Q2 on 1.41, you can make it this. Now, if you multiply this, this is first row into first column. See, you know, because this is 1 cross 2, this is 2 cross 2. If you solve it, you are going to get a 1 cross 2, like similarly. Okay, if you solve it, you are going to get this. Now, after this, if you simplification, if you do it, what is simplification? If you add these two values, you are going to get 0.278 Q2, then 0.1963 Q2, okay, then Q2 into 1.41 Q2. Now, still, if you go for simplification purpose, 0.278 Q2 square plus 0.1963 into 1.41, you're going to 0.2767 into Q2 square is equals to 1. So, if you simplify it, you're going to get 1.34, Q2 equals to 1.34. If Q2 equals to 1.34, see, if you observe Q2 equals to 1.34, 1.41 into Q2 becomes 1.41 into Q2. What is Q2? See, this is what? Q2 into 1.41 into Q2. What is Q2? 1.34. What is 1.41 into Q2? It will become 1.88. This is what your vector. Now, according to this, you should write a mode shape for it. What is the mode shape? Now, how to mention your mode shape? Now, write your mode shape. See, what is mode shape? How many nodes are there? 3 nodes are there. 1, 2, and 3. What is 1? 1 is fixed. This is your mean position. Okay, now, see, you can join the line like this. This is what mean position line. Okay, now, what is this? Now, I will take this is 1.34. Now, I will take this is a 1.88. Here, this is 1.88. Now, because it is at Q3, correct? This is at Q2. Q2 is 1.34. Now, just join a line. See, that means, now the body will oscillate like this. That means, it will move like this, This is what your vibration. Like a simple pendulum, it will oscillate like this. But how much X2, how much here? Here, it will be 1.34. How much this will be? 1.88. This is what your mode shape. We call it as a bending mode. Generally, we call it as a bending mode for the body. The body tend to oscillate in this direction. That means vector means it is giving in a direction how the body tend to oscillate. See, at what position it will oscillate? When a frequency is reached to a, what is the lambda 1 or what is omega 1? Omega 1 is reached to 1.053 into 10 power 3 radians per second or 167.61 hertz. When a body reaches to that frequency, the body will be oscillating in this manner. That is what the meaning of your mode shape and your frequency. Now, similarly, repeat the same procedure for determining your eigenvector 2. Now, k minus lambda m into x2. Now, simplify this. Okay. Now, what you want to make it? Replace lambda by lambda 2. Now, x2 will be q1, q2, q3. q1 equals to 0. Repeat same thing. Okay. I've taken the same reference. You can change the reference also. You can solve the problem. No problem. See, but I'd use same q1, q2, q3 as a reference. That's it. Okay, lambda equals to lambda 2, 13.54. Now substitute lambda 2 in this equation. See what is the values you are going to get. Now if you simplify it, you are going to get a value like this. That means if you solve after this lambda 2 substitution, you are going to get minus 1.7296 10 power 6, minus 1.22 into 10 power 6, minus 1 by this, and Q2, Q3 equals to 0. Now if you solve, here also if you use any of the equation, value will be same. Minus 1.729 into 10 power 6 into Q2. Minus 1.322 into 10 power 6 into Q2 is equals to 0. You are going to get this. Now if you solve this, Q3 will be equal to, I want, see, this is Q3, sorry, Q3. Q3 will be equal to, that means Q3, I'll keep it this side. This will minus as it is. Q3 will be equal to minus 1.729 in 10 power 6, 1.22 into, what is hands here? You are going to get into Q2. Okay, that is minus 1.41 into Q2. See, what is this? What is X2 transpose? Q2, Q3. That is Q2 into minus 1.41 into Q2. Now, you want to draw your mode shape. Once again, go for your normalization technique. X2 transpose M into X2 is equals to 1. What is Q2? Already you obtain. Write it. In the matrix, you write it. You solve this, you are going to get this value. Now, once again, you multiply first this, first point to first column, you are going to get this. Q2 into this, minus this, if you multiply it, you are going to get this value, 0.0724 into Q2. Then Q2 into 0.0514, minus this into this, you are going to get this value. Okay, now if you go for simplification of it, you are going to get this value will be 0.1332 into Q2, minus 0.0935 into Q2. Okay, into Q2 into minus 1.41 into Q2. Now, once again, if you multiply these two, you are going to get Q2 square will be equal to 1 by 0.265. If you simplify it, you are going to get that value is, if I write here, 0.1332 into Q2 square, because this into this, minus and minus plus, that is 0.1318 into Q2 square is equals to 1. If you solve it, you are going to get, that is Q2 equals to 1.94. We know what is X2 transpose, Q2 into minus 1.41 Q2. Now, I'll write here, see, X2 into this. Now, if you multiply, what is Q2? 1.94. What is X2? Minus 1.4 into Q2. If you multiply, you are going to get this. Now, for this, you want to write a mode shape. How to write mode shape? Repeat the same what you have written for previous. Take one line, draw a mean position, because this is your fixed end. Okay, 1. Now, take a node 2 here. Take node 3 here. Then I take 3 nodes. Now, just observe. See, if I take a scale like this, x-axis like this, say x-axis or y-axis like this, somewhere I'm going to get 1.94 here, okay? 1.94, you can take it as a 1.94. Okay, similarly, if I take downwards, somewhere I can write here, minus 2.73, okay? Minus 2.73. Now, the body, just write here, join this, okay? This is your node 2. Then, node 3, it is like this. Join here. This is your node 3. This is called your mode shape 2. Mode shape 2, or generally call it as an air. Mode shape 2, generally called as a twisting mode. Generally called as a twisting mode. This is how you can determine your eigenvalue or eigenvector for the constant cross section bar. Thank you.